Emily says you're working with her on bugging the Lucky 38. That information would be invaluable to our research if you can get it done. We're always looking for new members. Does he have any particular talent? Excellent. Ezekiel's been after me to find him a new assistant for ages. Tell the boy we'll take him.
If we run, we might still catch Benny. Well, you might. I'll just be wheezing along behind you.
Sure, boss. What do you want to know?
You forget about me already, boss? You sure you didn't take a blow to the head or something? My name is Raul Alfonso Tejada.
Probably because it used to be Miguel's.
I'm an open book, boss. Granted, the book's in Spanish and some of the pages have fallen out, but I'm an open book. I'm not much use besides being a portable encyclopedia, really. I guess you could use me as a pack Brahmin, but my knees aren't so good anymore. That's nice of you to say, boss, but I'm an old man. Not much use to anybody anymore. Time was. I was a pretty good shot with a pistol. I guess I'm still half decent. These old bones aren't much use in hand-to-hand fighting, though. I can also do maintenance work on your stuff. I don't have the supplies for a real repair job, but I can keep your gear working longer.
It's a sin, my darling.
Yeah, maybe you can introduce them to me, if we find them, because I've never met one. I was born just outside Mexico City. My family had a little ranch there. Old enough to know better, boss. Old enough to know better.
The dream I built for us has tumbled.
Well, boss, when a giant insane super mutant asks you to stay put, you do what you're told. Well, maybe you don't. But I'm just a broke-down old man. It's stupid, boss. I used to listen to the radio broadcast just to pass the time. Well, one day the signal stopped, so I figured I'd try to find the transmitter. I'm a pretty good repairman. Or I was before my eyes started to go. Anyway, I found Black Mountain and offered my services. But Tabitha decided I was useful enough to keep around permanently.
What? They did? Oh, that's great. Thank you. I'm out of this crummy camp.
Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have too much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly all around.
You should go talk to Blake or Alice. They handle most of our contact with visitors. I watch all sorts of things with my binoculars. Who wants to know? And why? Nice looking blonde boy? I always wondered if he was watching me back. What's he like? Really? Oh, that's so sweet. I'd love to go meet him. Is there any way the boomers would let me visit Nellis? This is so exciting. Let me know how it turns out.
Hello, friend. Well, well, this is welcome news.
Who?
This presents a bit of a problem. Jack isn't allowed to leave Nellis, and I doubt she would make it through the artillery alive. I suppose Jack deserves a chance at love. You can tell Jack she has a free pass to enter, but he is responsible for her actions. Do not make me regret this decision, outsider. Bye.
This has been a dream come true to work on the lady. I don't think I've seen Loyal this frisky in years. Here, take this boomer outfit. I'll let the gunners know she's coming, and not to shoot at her. This has been a dream come true. Like I said.
Hello again. How's your... I was hoping you would. What's going on? Have they agreed to my safety yet? Well, with McLafferty dead, I guess my contract is done and I'm free to leave. I'm off to meet my admirer. Nelson will serve as example. We'll bleed the ground red with anyone who opposes our peace efforts.
This has been a dream come true.
Hello. It's great to finally meet you.
Hi there. It's great to meet you as well.
I'm glad you made it out here. You're even more stunning up close than you were at distance.
Crawl around the dirt to keep
and you're even more handsome up close. Do you think it'll be okay if I hang around here for a little while so we can get to know each other better?
Of course it would. I'll have you set up with some quarters with some of the other women. You've done us a great service. Thank you for your help.
Nelson will serve.
Thank you for getting Janet to Nellis. I've never been so happy in my entire life.
As example. Thank you for getting me here. Jack is a great guy.
I expect to be awed by your dizzying mercantile sense, boss. I expect to be awed by your dizzying mercantile sense, boss.
Those Legion Elite troops are bad blood. We're being held here against our freedom. Thank God Frank thinks we're enslaved. Now we can actually start fresh. Thank you for helping us.
Thank you so much for freeing me.
Hey, No one but Omer. You'll get these back.
Hello and welcome to Gamora. What can I help you with today? Feel free to head to our club, Brimstone, or you can see our gorgeous courtyard out behind the casino. I've heard some pretty shady rumors about the Ultralux. I'm not sure what the deal is, but although they try to put on airs, that place is just plain creepy. Maybe it's the masks. I knew someone would call in that mark soon. What do you want to know? All I can tell you is to find Cachino. He's the lowest level lieutenant you're going to be able to talk to. Some of the girls say he's been involved in some shady business the family wouldn't really like. Ask him about it. Not much of a rumor, but I hear the Tops is always looking for new talent. Lord knows they've needed it for a long time. Bye.
Our Rangers are going to show everyone what happens when we're pissed off.
I hear you've been asking questions about me, dickweed. What the fuck do you want? Business? What the fuck do you mean, business? You looking to get yourself burned? Now you start talking real clear, and I mean fucking crystal clear, because I'm about to lose my patience. I don't give half a dick what you heard. Now get the fuck out of my face before I burn your sorry ass.
What do you need? Bye.
You again.
Where the fuck did you get that?
Okay, listen, buddy. That's some dangerous shit you got there. That book can get me killed if the wrong people see it. Let's talk. What do you want? What can I do for you?
I can't stop you, but that's gonna mean my death. I can make it worth your while to give it to me, though. Plus, if you go to the bosses, I can't help you stop what they've been doing.
I can pay you for it, of course. I also have some information about the family's business that you might find interesting. Between you and I, we can break up what they're planning, maybe save some lives. Mine included, of course. Oh, here's some caps. Now give me the journal. Right, there we go. So let me tell you what I know about the family's business. The bosses, Big Sal and Nero, have been working for a while on this. They're arming themselves like an army, using this new guy, Troik. They also brought in a specialist named Clandon. At least that's what they introduced him as. I got no fucking idea. They let him have the run of the place, though. He seems like a nice guy, but he makes me nervous. He's a little arrogant. But he's too nice, too open. I've never seen him fucking or gambling. Everyone has a vice, but this guy seems like the Pope. He's a skittish little fucker. Spends half the day pumping his body full of chems and the other half pumping hookers with his willy. He has some kind of connections, so he's able to smuggle huge shipments of weapons into the Strip. The bosses got him by the short hairs. We covered up a hooker he killed while flying on some psycho, so he gets his guns in exchange for not ratting. No, just that it involves guns and muscle. Also that it's big. Very big. Only Nero and Big Saul know everything, and they ain't telling. There's some serious shit going on between NCR and the Legion. You better not fuck with our power.
But if you stay, I love you. What if you're cruel? You can be kind, I know. There was never a man like my Johnny.
Hey, nice to meet you. Do you need help with something?
Like the one.
A little bit of this and a little bit of that.
Johnny Guitar.
I'm a close friend of some of the family around here. I do some independent contracting around the casino, and they set me up with this great room. I think I should kill you before you have a chance to show those tapes to anyone. What do I have to lose? Fuck, I was getting tired of this place anyways. I can find girls to play with somewhere else.
I hear you chased that chicken shit Benioff. Good riddance.
Who are you? I didn't do anything. Leave. I don't see how that's your business. I'm just a guest here, having a little fun. Oh, man. I don't even like to think about it. All that goddamn blood. It was just in the hotel like any other night. I took some Kims with the girl I was with, but I never black out. I did this time, though. Next thing I knew, I woke up, she was lying next to me, stabbed dead. There was a knife next to the bed, and I was covered in her blood. I keep a little switchblade tucked away with me. You never know when you might find some trouble. That night, mostly buff out. I like to cut it with a little bit of jet and wash it down with some whiskey. That was my standard Saturday night. What? Yeah, you're right. I wonder what was up with that. When I saw the body, I started screaming. In a few seconds, some of their soldiers were in there cleaning up the room. They offered to keep silent about what happened if I agreed to help them get their hands on large quantities of guns at deep discounts. You'd do that for me? I'm not sure what can be done, but you'd be doing me a solid if you would. I've been talking to Big Saul mostly. You again? Cachino? Cachino what? Are you kidding me? He must be trying to get me killed. Yeah? Well, fuck that. The bosses have my number and I'm a company man while they got the goods on me. More power to you if you can, but keep me out of it. I've been doing business with Big Saw, so he's going to be your man.
I hear Mr. House cashed out. Ain't much to miss.
Hey, you're Cachino's friend. You got business with me? Ah, Trike. What you want? Some more jet? A fresh batch of girls? Maybe a guy or two this time. Why would I want to do that? Yeah, I see where you're coming from. Okay, tell Troik he can hit the rope. We run a hotel. What do you think our business is?
Bosses don't like no trouble in their place.
You again? Holy shit. Really? Okay, I'll help you. But I'm getting the hell out of here first chance I get. They're keeping them in a little utility section down off the basement. I don't know what they're arming themselves for, but I know it isn't for the good of mankind. I've made a lot of contacts over the years. I have some friends back in California that can get their hands on just about anything. Mostly, I've been calling in every last favor I have. I'm pretty proud of myself. It's a stroke of genius if I could be so modest. The whole arrangement starts with an old buddy of mine in the Republic. He's responsible for packing and shipping supplies to the NCR on the Strip. He marks some containers as food and medical and packs them with guns and other shit. From there, it took just a couple of greased palms to get someone to let me cherry pick a container or two out of every shipment. Easy as pie. As a little pet project, I've been making some thermite. Thermite burns as hot as the devil's asshole and can melt through just about anything. I've been keeping it so if the family betrays me, I can hopefully do some damage before I end up dead or in jail. Hey, fuck you. Alright, I'll place the fucking thermite myself. You get out of the casino for a bit. I'll take care of it while you're gone.
He's
bosses don't like no trouble in their place.
In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men had tried to take him, and that many men were dead. He was vicious and a killer, though a youth of 24, and the notches on his pistol numbered 1 in 19 more.
Hey, what can I do for you?
Now the stranger started talking, made it plain.
You better get outside for a little bit. I'm sure they're gonna look for the infamous courier when things go to hell. Hey, what can I do for you? I hear you chased that chicken shit Benny off. Good riddance.
20 men had tried to take him. 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big turn on his hip. The morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 11:20
I expect to be awed by your dizzy mercantile sense, boss.
They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death.
Welcome back to Gamora. I know you're good for it, but you're still gonna have to leave your weapons with me.
And the swiftness of the ranger is still talked about today.
I expect to be awed by...
It was over in a moment and the folks had gathered round. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match the ranger.
Things are getting stranger every day.
Big iron on his hip. Big iron, big iron. When he tried to match the ranger with the big iron on his hip, big iron on his hip.
Welcome back to Gamora.
Glad that fucker house is gone. Hey, what can I do for you?
Yeah, poor fucker got himself caught after he melted all the guns. Bastard mentioned your name before they shot him in the head. Now the bosses want to see you. Oh, is that right? Well, I guess if he's gone, he's gone. I don't need to know anything more than that.
Now we cut off the head of the serpent. Big Saul and Nero have to die. When they're gone, I'm gonna run this joint. Don't worry, I'll take care of this place. They're a little bit upset about what's been done to muck up their plans. Task me to find out who's responsible. There isn't gonna be another chance to get both of them together in the same room. I'll slip you a gun and we can take them out.
You got sense enough to know it's a sin to tell a lie. Whole lot of folks' heart is done, been broken.
All right, I'll take care of them. Just give me the word when to start shooting. Hurry and get ready. I'll be waiting for you there when you're ready. Yes, I do. I know. If you break my heart, Hey, what can I do for you? Hey, I'll take care of them when you're ready. Just say the word. I suggest doing it while they're talking.
Let's have some words. Take a seat on the couch so we can get to talking. So I assume you know why we called you here. Well, you've been a real thorn in our side. We've got business plans. You set us back a little bit, I'll admit that. However, we wanted you to know that nothing you did made a shit bit of difference, and you're going to die a fit. And you shitting me. You didn't even know what the plan was. Yeah. As a last request, I guess we can give you that courtesy. Caesar asked us to provide a distraction on this trip, so when he gives the word, we're gonna launch an all-out assault on this trip. First, we're gonna blow the embassy, then we're gonna use soldiers to kill every last motherfucker on this trip. Then we'll run this joint. That'll teach Nod at home what can go on while he sits in his fucking ivory tower lording down from on high. Fuck. I knew there had to be someone higher up helping you. Nero, you backstabbing, two-timing motherfucker. I knew this day would come.
I'm here!
Hey!
No way I'm
sticking around here. Come on!
Hey, thanks for all the hard work back there. I'm gonna run a tight ship here, don't you worry. Of course, after all you did for me, here are some chips for you. Play, have some fun. Bye.